given the form transaction of database D, build the virtual pattern tree. Transactions are A, B, D, E, B, C, D, A, B, D, E, A, C, D, E, here, which is on the website, we're going to update it. The TAs are going to update it because it says it's not asking to mine the FP tree. So that's not true. You're going to have to do the mining of the FP tree. So some of you have gotten confused when we did this exercise. We have two steps. One is to build the FP tree and second is to mine the FP tree. So you have to do both of these on the exam. So the TAs will update this document to remove this data from there. So the first thing we're going to do is to order the transactions according to the most frequently occurring items. So let's see which items are occurring most frequently. And we order the transaction in descending order. We have A, B, C, D, E. These are our items. How many times did the A happen in the transaction? One, two, three, four, five. Right? And B? One, two, three, four, five,
seven.
Seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And C?
Five.
One, two, three,
four.
Four and five.
One, two, three, two, three,
four,
five. And D?
Eight.
Eight?
Nine.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. E is happening all the time. E?
Six.
One, two, three, four, five, six. So now we need to order them starting with which one first? D, because D is the most frequent. So we will order them in descending order. D will be the first. Next is one.
B7.
B will be next. Probably 7, and then?
E.
We have A and C are the same number, 5. Now,
E,
what
E, E6. Six.
Huh?
E6.
E is 6. So next is E?
Yeah.
And next what?
A.
If we have two of them with the same number, we go by alphabetical order. So this way, the core class will have the same answer. So we have first A and then C. So we're going to reorder the transactions by this order. First transaction will become D, B, E, A. So we're following this order, D, B, E, A, for the best transaction. Number one, the next one will become what? D, C, B. No, G,
B,
B, C. Next one will become D, B,
E,
E, and then A. And this one?
B-B-E-C.
What is this one?
B-B-E-C.
And this one? This one?
B,
B,
A, C.
B, A, C.
D.
And this one?
B,
E,
D,
D,
E,
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 A. Tree by creating the root, which is null. So the root of the tree is null. Set is count equal to 1 and place a link to it from the parent. And we go to the next item in the transaction, which is D. So we are here now, and we are asking if we have a child named B.
No.
No? If we don't, we create. Set discount equal to 1. Place the link to it from the parent. Transaction when we go to a new transaction, we will start from the root again. So we are in the first item from this transaction, which is D. Do we have a child named D?
Yes,
if we do, what are we going to do?
I don't want
to. Implement the count. So we're incrementing it. Increment the count. So the count is 2 now for D. And we are here. We go to the next item. Next item would be. Do we have a child named B? Yes. So what are we going to do? Increment the count. Now this is 2. And we are here now. Next item. From the transaction is C. Do we have a child named C? No, if we don't, then we create. So C will be right here. Put a link to it from the parent, and its count is equal to 1. Thank you. done, we have a new transaction, we start from the root. First item transaction is D. So we're just going to increment the count for D. Next item is B. So we will increment the count for B. Next item is E. We do our job name E. We will increment the count. Next item is A. We do have a job name A. Increment the count. And we're done with this transaction. Going to the next transaction. First item is D. Looking the tree, we start from the null because we are in a new transaction. We do have an item named D. We're just going to increment the count. section number six. Start from the roots. The first item is me again, our favorite item. So we do have D, we will increment cap to six now. Next is B. We do have B. Increment the gown to five. Next is E. We do have E. So increment the gown to four. And transaction number seven. Starting with D again. D is right here. We have it. Discount is incremented. Next item is C. Now we are over here. And the next item is C. So there's going to be C over here. Some of you are asking if this is a binary tree. Is this a binary tree? Now the D has three links coming out. The binary tree will put two links all the time. So we're done with this transaction. Transaction number eight, starting with B. Alright, so we have something different now. We are at the null and there is a B. So B is right here. We have a child named B. So we create a new branch off of the roots for B. This tree is not really ugly. I'm gonna put the CEO here. Transaction number nine, starting from the root. Do we have a child named D?
Yep.
Yes, if we do increment count, count is not eight or D. Thank you. in A. Yes. So the count for A will be 2 now. And the last transaction. First item is D, our favorite item. We do have D, and the count will become 9. Count for D is 9. The next item is B. So you have that on Moodle, so please look at that. Also, we've got two more problems.